Bonjour, bonjour les amis. So as you can see today I'm going to the supermarket, so I'm here on the parking. So what I will do is I will go inside and I will show you how it looks like. So it's about little bit the same as anywhere else in the world, you know, supermarket is supermarket. What I will do is I will teach you the few words of the different parts of the supermarket. First of all, we are here on the parking. Le parking. Le parking. Le parking. Let's go inside. And usually what you do, you take a trolley. The trolley will say le caddie. Le caddie. Le caddie. And this is for the kid. So c'est kid caddie. And let's go inside. On y va. So here we are. At the entrance. So at the entrance you have a first part of the supermarket where they sell usually the everyday products. So this is the shoes, the clothes, you know. You say les chaussures, les habits, the shoes, les chaussures, les habits, the clothes. And here you have everything that's about the books, les livres, le papier. Here we have the toys, you know. And here you have everything that you for the garden and for fishing or hunting, you know. And then we'll reach the part that is about the shopping mall, all the food and the food product. So since we are in the countryside, what they have, there will be many grains like this. And they have a few, I don't know, you still have the possibility to buy this kind of grain, you know. I don't do it, I wish I could, and I will if I come back to France at some point, but in China there is no possibility to do this. Last year I wanted to bring back this to China, but then you are not allowed to do this. You are not allowed to bring this kind of product and cross the border. In this part you have the electricity. You have a little bit everything. I will just move around. So today there are many people because it's the wrong time. It's about 5-6 o'clock, and apparently it's cheaper if you shop today. It's cheaper. So that's it. You have the meat here, and over there the fish. Meat, the fish, le poisson, et la viande. And over there you have the bakery, the bread, la boulangerie. So here it is, so the bread, le pain, and the pastry. Toilet paper and everything to clean the house, to clean the floor. Okay, let's go on the other side where you will find seeing the fruits. I know the fruits and maybe cheese and everything. I never buy the bread from here because their bread is usually very bad, you know? So here they have all the electronic products for a coffee machine, the cooking tools, you know, cooking machine. You know. As you can see, you always have the possibility to buy the meat from the butcher here that they have inside, or directly here from the shelf. In the shelf, it's already pre-cut and usually cheaper. And it's the same for the cheese. You can always buy here from the right, or you can buy the prepared the already prepared one that comes directly from the factory. At some point, the supermarket, many smaller shops, they complain about the supermarket. That's true that they killed the small shop, you know, because they opened their own butcher. Here, as you can see, their own cheesemaker, their own bakery inside the shopping mall. And it killed everything. At the beginning, you only had this, which is just the product that's cheaper, that comes from the supermarket. But then they developed the choice. Like you have the choice between taking this kind of product that comes from supermarket. The quality is lower. The taste is fine, but in fact, when you look at the component, it's really not good. they put a lot of you know, things so that you can keep it longer, and the meat quality is the worst, of course. But again, it's cheaper. All the beauty product, shaving product, rasage. Well, it's the same as any supermarket. You have the labels, you know, labels, baby, you know, right here, baby, baby product. Here the fruits and the vegetables, les fruits, les légumes, and here you have all the frozen product. So what happened in France is many people, they don't have time to cook, so they buy just the frozen product. This is prepared. You just, all you have is to heat it up, warm it up. So either with the microwave, either with the oven. Here even you can. This, I think this is not cooked at all. I mean, no, this is already prepared. But sometimes what they do is they just cut the vegetable for you. And exist, for instance, green bean. So they are just prepared green beans that you have to cook by yourself. But it's not cooked, you know. It's just prepared. Some are the prepared dish. Some are just the prepared vegetable. So. I'm not sure about it. I heard one thing is maybe it might be a little bit dirty, but I don't think, I'm not sure if the vegetable will lose their nutrients if it's frozen. But at least it's convenient. Here you have also all the sandwich. You don't have as many as if you, I worked in the UK once, I remember it was huge, but here we only have this part. These are also the all the prepared dish that you have microwave. It's not the frozen one, so it's usually what people eat at lunchtime, you know. So this is all the biscuits and chocolate. So this is a huge choice. Now I don't take anything like this anymore. I used to take the chocolate, le chocolat ici. Now I don't take it anymore. I think gluten is bad. You know, when you take the sugar, all this is full of sugar and it kills your nutrients. So it will make you weak and weak and weak. It's also very acid for the body. The sweets used to be way, way bigger, but now French people are really wary of sweets. They don't eat so many sweets. The packs are much smaller. They used to be much bigger. They are much smaller. So sometimes the parents, they will buy for the kids, but they don't buy the huge packs. They buy the packs that you have now. This is the American brand, you know, Mars and all this. In fact, many huge multi, all this is, are, you have only, if you look at all these products that you find in the supermarket, biscuits or chocolate or sweets, bonbons, you only find, in fact, two or three main multinational, and they have all their product, and they bought back all the brands. This is to bake your own cake. So, in fact, here we are in the supermarket from the countryside. So you have many people in the countryside. They are older people. They have more time. Maybe they don't work. They make less money, so they have time, more time to cook. So they will bake their own cake. Therefore, you have a different choice, you know. The jam, French people like to take the jam for breakfast, the jam and Nutella. You know, Nutella is one of the best selling product here, Nutella, it's a Lotus, you know. This is very tasty, but I wouldn't advise it. The honey, so you have all the scam that I told you about, so they say AB, oh, it's organic and all, but in fact it doesn't come from France, it often comes from China. So you need to check and really look at the very, very small handwriting. They will not even write that it's China, but they will tell you, come from outside of the EU, of the European Union, in fact it's China. Here you have the coffee, French people take coffee for breakfast, as I told you. So, what else? Let me go up a little bit. I didn't do this part. You have now many French people, what they do, they simply use the machine, coffee machine or tea machine, and they, for their product. This part is interesting. It's for all the animals. Since we are in the countryside, I guess we have more choice. So you have for the cats, for the dogs, but also maybe for the horse. You see here you have the rabbit, le lapin, the cochon d'Inde, you know, many different things. Look, this is huge. It's for le chien, for the dogs. Yeah. This is for the cats on the right. You know, the biggest brand all over the world that prepared cat food and pet food, they are the French brand, you know. So we have Whiskas, this one, you know, Pedigree, it's everywhere. I've seen it in China. They started to sell it everywhere because so many French people have pets, you know. Maybe one French people for every four people. 1/4 of the population has a pet. So. The drinks, the drinks. Well, this is usual. I'm just going to go through. Not that interesting. This is what you find everywhere, you know. Coke. Remember, once I went to the US when I was a kid, and I was asking for people Coca-Cola, because in French we say Coke is Coca-Cola, you know, Coca-Cola. People say, what is Coca-Cola? But you drink Coca-Cola all the time in the US. Ah, Coke, okay. And after that, everybody was making fun of me. The beer is okay in France. You have French beer and beer from Belgium. Usually when it's packed like this, the taste is a little bit better. I don't drink beer also. This one is also good, pressure beer. They have this, the big one, which is much better, le fût pression, which is cheaper, but you need to drink it in a short time or with some friends. Here, of course, we also have a lot of wine, you know. So, les alcools, this you have it everywhere, hein? The rum, the whiskey. In fact, it's really international. It's really a shame, in fact, I want to say, because you see, this is France, right? We are not a country of whiskey, huh? Sorry for my friend from the UK, but we are not a country of whiskey, and all this is whiskey, you know? We should not sell whiskey in France. We should sell, the French product, you know? And when you look at it in these huge supermarkets, all this is look, the big brand from whiskey, all this is not France, you know. This is not French product. It's the same for vodka, for, you know. So that's globalization. You only have the global product. This is interesting. You have a cidre, which is a apple product, apple wine, you know, apple wine. So it's interesting. Donc here, what didn't show you? The canned fish, I like to take this, it's very, really nice, very good. The tuna fish, but tuna is endangered species. We'll soon have no more tuna inside the sea, but whatever, you know, soon we'll be all gone anyway. So, and sardine, also something you can keep at home, can keep for a very long time. These days I saw this, that even in Germany, the authorities told the German people, it's better if you keep some food and make sure that you have enough food at home in case there is a problem. You should have some food prepared for yourself at home. So I'm not doing it because I cannot in China, but if I were here, I would buy some sardine, because you can keep this for 3-4 years. And that's fine. Look here, this is the snails. Usually this kind of prepared food is not that good, but these are old brands, and I think this is kind of local. You don't find this in other supermarkets. You find this because we are in the countryside. So we have les tripes. Les tripes, this is the inside of the pig. This is from the duck. From the duck, yes. This is the snails. You don't find this in all supermarket. This is also all the prepared dish, you know, prepared French dish. I usually never have this, but you can try it. I never take this, but it gives you an idea, but it's not very good. It gives you an idea what people eat. And also, these are, of course, French dish, traditional French dish. You know, hachis parmentier is the smashed potatoes with ham, you know. This one is not French dish, but bœuf bourguignon, beef. But you can cook it by yourself. It's not that difficult if you have the time. And this will be cheaper and better. This is rather cheap, but still, $2.35, this is rather cheap. But of course, they will add many things inside, so it's not good, it's not healthy. Let me just check the last one, and okay, the sugar and the pastry, and over there you have the milk, I can see. So, and spaghetti, people like to buy spaghetti, it's easy to prepare the chips, you know. Chips, you don't have that many chips here. Remember that it's inside the countryside. When you are in Paris, you have way more chips. You have a lot of alcohol, a lot of wine. This is the case everywhere. These are all wine from France, from different location. That's it, you know. And here you have the Miak product over there. I don't want to go there too much because you have people, and then they might ask me not to film, which I'm not allowed to do normally, but whatever, you know. And here you have the dessert, you know. You always have many people in the dessert section. Cheese on the left and the dessert on the right. Let's have a look at the cheese, you know. So again, these are all cheese from different parts of France. We have here the Camembert, which comes from Normandy in the north of France, and you have different type of cheese. But usually I never buy my cheese here because the quality is rather low. I would rather just buy tasty cheese that comes from a real cheese maker, a real shop, rather than take this. I would rather pay more and have less quantity. Because I would rather have less quantity and quality and taste. These are all the spices that you can use to cook. You know, most people, what they will use is herbe de Provence, you know, or maybe basilic, you know, basil. What else? Many of these, in fact, you can find in fresh. You don't need to find it like this. So it's maybe the black pepper, the salt, sea salt, the curcuma. This you cannot find fresh, so you will buy it here. The rest, maybe the ginger, you cannot find so many fresh here, ginger. But the rest, you will take it fresh from the... Well, here is more like Asian stuff, you know. Here, and organic, there is a part that they put some organic product, organic biscuits. This is, they're trying to do competition with the shops that I showed you that offer some a choice of organic organic food. Usually these brands are German brands, you know, so it's kind of a shame since in France we are a big country for agriculture and we are not able to develop organic product, you know. And I'm done, I will just look at the last part here and I will leave you. We have already seen this, so maybe let's have a look just over there and then I will leave you. We'll just go at the part where they show you the fruit and the vegetable. Yes, this is something interesting, but this is this guy here. You have all the juice and the prepared salad here, you know. Okay. Maybe on the other side I will just try to have a look because, and I can go through the cheese once more, because I want to show you the vegetable so you can see a little bit. But the cheese, if you are a foreigner and you come to France for the first time, you are not accustomed to cheese, it's likely that you are not like all the soft cheese like this, that are soft, like this one is soft, this is soft. You are not like it too much. The goat cheese is very special, it's all soft, it's not cooked. So. And Camembert, Roquefort, all this, you will not like it. What you will probably like though is this, maybe Emmental, you know, Comté, you know, because it's cooked cheese, so it's easier for people who are not accustomed to cheese. Comté has a little bit of strong taste, so I would advise to start maybe Gruyère. But really, if you want to have the real taste of the cheese, don't start here, just buy from a real cheese maker, don't buy from here. And also many foreigners, they like this. Why? Because it's the cheese that you can, even it's not cooked, it's the cheese that you can use on the bread and just put it on the bread. And apparently this brand is quite old, Boursin, you know, it's the cheese that you can see that you can put on the bread and it's suitable for many people's taste. I'm not sure why, you know. But it's how it is. This one is also, I think you have it all over the world, you know. But this is, again, they will use the bad milk. The way they produce it is not good. The milk is polluted more and more. They don't pay the employees well. So I just say don't buy it, you know. Don't buy it here. If you have the possibility, just choose to eat less and eat better quality. And here is the better. Here you see they have their own cheese shops, which is a little bit higher quality, but still not that. And just to show you here the vegetable. So here you have, and I'm done. Okay, so you have seen a little bit everything. So they were nice, they didn't tell me, they didn't care too much, but I'm worried because sometimes people can be really nasty and I don't want this to happen, you know. It's really not nice when people start telling you, hey, what are you doing? And then you get, it happened to me last time and I was like, hey, it doesn't matter, I'm going, and then they wanted to take my camera and all this, so whatever, you know, it's life. So I'm going and this is interesting, you have a... Well, it's interesting because it seems to be a local brand. So sometimes you see, and that's what they are doing. Look, they did this and they say 100% French, and then they say this is the ice cream that they produce here. Sometimes these supermarkets, they will have the product like this, or maybe it's good to try it. You have ice cream and sorbet. Sorbet is only water and fruit. Ice cream is more with milk, you know. Okay, bon, and you have a few flowers in the middle. So you've seen it, French supermarket, you know. So see you next time. Oh, this is something, a specialty of France, and sausage, saucisson. Usually foreigners don't like it. This is the Spanish one, chorizo, because it's a little bit spicy. It's just pig, in fact, but foreigners don't like it, but I like it, of course. Of, I mean, many foreigners don't like it. Okay, okay. See you next time. Au revoir, les amis. Hein. À bientôt.